Welcome to our channel. Before going to the session, I would like to request you kindly subscribe my channel. Please subscribe my channel. This is a back-to-back process. What do you mean by back-to-back process? When you are buying the goods or a product from supplier and delivering to the your customer in one cycle, that is back-to-back order. So I am going to cover these topics in the session. So I am giving the highlight of these topics. These are the screen we will see during the session. So please be with us next 10 to 12 minutes and it will give you understanding regarding the back-to-back order. Please don't leave. It's a very, very short video. It is not a lengthy video. I made it in up to 12 minutes only. So I am showing the auto convert requisition to purchase order with a click. Several type of steps I am showing here. And these topics will be shown during the session. We will also see the inventory updated, how the inventory is being updated, and how fulfillment will be done. So kindly, again, I will request, kindly subscribe my channel. This is my 12th video. And I will give you many videos on EBS. Now coming to our session, I will show right now the item master setup. What are the item masters setup is required for back-to-back items. So I have created one item, back-to-back item already. So kindly see the what are the setup for the back-to-back. So I am taking to your every tabs and see the setup. Assemble to order is required for the back-to-back orders, because you are buying the goods or you are giving the order to your supplier to assemble or manufacturing the goods. That's why ATU flag is required. It is must, then only it will be treated as a back-to-back sales order. So please flag ATO at the time of item creation. Organization now coming to the sales order creation. Select the customer. Create the sales order, book the order. Select the item, back-to-back item. One item you entered. Now book the sales order. You see, there is no stock. That's why this message is giving. Quantity on hand fails to satisfy requisition. Since we don't have any stock, but we are creating the sales order. We are giving the order to the supplier. And we will buy the goods. This is a very, very important to create a supply order eligible from the tool. You need to do these things. Okay. Now we are going to requisition import, because we will create the requisition for the buying the goods. So in P2P, what is the cycle? You need to create the requisition. For that, we are running the one requisition import. After this process, there will be one requisition number will be created, one requisition will be created. You can see the requisition number from sales order. And after requisition, there will be one purchase order will be created. I will show you just now. Just be here. You will see the requisition number. Reservation details. See, 16409 requisition already has been created just now. We have executed the concurrent program requisition import. Based on the sales order, requisition has been created. It is a external requisition. Just you saw that is external requisition. You see that external requisition. After this process, you will create the purchase order. Definitely in P2P cycle, you will see the after requisition PO will be created. Similar activities will be performed here also. Since we have created the purchase order, that is the auto purchase order. One thing I would like to say that the importing the requisition, creating the requisition auto order creation can be clubbed together and attached to the workflow. So there is no need to create this process manually. We will create a transaction type, and these activities can be attached to the workflow. So it will be automatic, can be created. But I am going to show the what are the main steps are being done in the back-to-back order. That's why I kept open. I am doing the manually this part. It can be done through the workflow also. You can add these activities to the, since the order is being created here, auto order. Approve the purchase order. Kindly subscribe my channel only. I will request, please subscribe my channel. My next video will be in sourcing and advanced pricing. Now I am created the purchase order. Purchase order has been created through the auto create. It is a one kind of auto create. This process can be automated through the workflow also. Now they receive the goods in Seattle manufacturing. Entry order. You need to receive the goods or a product, whatever it is. So we are doing the item receipt. These activities is being performed here. It will update the stock. With subent inventory is required, you need to enter the subentry inventory part. So from here, actual stock will be updated. Earlier, there was no stock. Now we have purchased quantity 1. So we will see the stock will be 1. There will be concurrent program automatically is being fired, received, receiving the goods. So concurrent program will be fired automatically at the time of receive the good. Again, I will request kindly subscribe my channel. Now I will show the stock has been updated or not. You can. Querying the particular item, seeing the stock. See, quantity 1 has been updated. Now we will do the fulfillment. Delivery the goods to the customer. Now, what are the process we have completed? We have purchased, we are delivering the goods, product to our customer. That part is with fulfillment. It is called fulfillment. Doing the pick release, ship confirm, and it will be delivered to the customer. That part is being performed here. So we are doing the sales release, sales order for picking. It will be a picked. You see the status, it will be picked. Now we will be the ship confirm. I will show the status of the sales order. You will see that there will, it should be a picked. The status is picked here. Now the actual ship confirm. Now next step is ship confirm. Doing the ship confirm, delivery was successful confirmed. Now it is minus from our stock and delivered to the goods. Similar type of documents have been created at the time of shipping. Now our entire process is completed. Starting from item setup to delivered. Now we will see the final status. It definitely it will be a shipped. Now it is it. Stay tuned for the expert tips of the sourcing and advanced pricing. Subscribe now and don't miss our next video. So kindly subscribe. I'm requesting you kindly subscribe, like, and give your comment. It will be good for me. I will definitely upgrade my comment. Thank you.